In this video, I will teach you how to create a header with Elementor Pro and Flexbox container. Hey guys, how are you? Here is Michaela from Simplifying Websites. Before the tutorial, I will ask you to leave a like on the video and subscribe to the channel, okay? So, let's go to the tutorial. So come on guys, I'm here on the MacCreative website, which is a portfolio site that I taught you to create here on the channel. I'll leave the link in the card and in the description if you want to learn how to create this project, okay? In the video of the project, I taught you how to create a header too, but I took it out here so I could teach it again. Elementor has recently updated, changed the way of making headers a little bit, so I'm teaching you again. Look, when you don't activate a header by Elementor, a header model with Elementor, this header is on top, which is the theme header. So here is the title of the site. Sometimes if you have a registered logo, the logo is here. This is normal, okay? Only when you configure the Elementor header or another header to subscribe, or if you come there on the theme and disable it, the header will disappear here, okay? The first thing we have to do is create a header here in WordPress, because with Elementor, what we do is customize what we already have on the site. So we can come here, we came here in appearance menus. Here in mine, I already have one. That's why it's showing up here. But in yours, it will be like this. Look. Even if you want to create a new one, just click here to create a new one. You don't need to click there if it's the first time you're doing it, because it's going to look empty, see? Then you come here and put a name for your header. I'll write main menu and click down here to create header. And then we'll start creating the links here. I already have some registered pages here, so I have the home page, which is the main page. When you click here to see everything, you see all the pages. I have the contact page and I have the Our Solutions page. Then you select the pages you want and click here to add to the header. Then you can come here dragging to put in the order you want, but I still want to put some more links that are not pages. They are parts of the page itself, right? That doesn't have a page, it's just here. So I'm going to do what we call anchor. So for example, I want it to come here to this part of the portfolio, see? So I'm going to create a link for us to call here in the portfolio. And to do this, we can come here in custom links, then we click here and write the text that will appear, which is, for example, do you see that it says home here? So it's this text, this title that we're going to put here. So I'm going to put portfolio, for example. And here we put the link. In our case, since we want to make an anchor link, right? For this place here, what am I going to do? I'm going to get the link from our website, right? From the main page. I'm going to paste here, and then here at the end, do you see that it came with a bar? I have to leave this bar. I'm going to put a hashtag, and then I'm going to put an ID, which is an ID that we're going to configure here in this part, okay? Then I'm going to call it portfolio. The ID, you can't put the score or the seed, okay? So it has to be in lowercase, and it has to be without a score. So I wrote portfolio. Remember, you have to have the bar here first, okay? I'm going to click on Add to Menu, look. I'm going to put it up here. I'm going to put this part here too, about us, right? So, I'm going to write here, about us, and then up here, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to paste the link. I'm going to write here at the end, hashtag about us. I wrote it all together without an accent, and I'm going to add it. Then I'm going to go up here. It's going to be home, about us, portfolio, our solutions and contact. Then I'm going to click here on save menu, okay? Then we've already created our header here in WordPress. So much so that if we reload here, nothing happens. It still doesn't show up here. Then we have to create it here with Elementor. We're going to come here in Models, Add New. Let's choose the header option here. Then I'm going to give a name here to our header model. I'm going to put main menu here too. And I'm going to click on Create Model. When we open it, here in the Elementor library, there are already some models ready here that we can click on Insert and adapt part of it. But I'm going to create one from scratch here with you, okay? I'm going to close this tab. Then I'm going to come here. I'm going to get it. I'm creating it here with Flexbox container, okay? That's why this arrow is showing up down and to the side. Then you will come here in Elementor, Settings, Resources. Flexbox container, leave it active and come down here and save, okay? If you want to use this new technology, which is Flexbox container, there's even a video on the channel teaching you how it works here, okay? So I'm going to click here. I'm going to get a container with the arrow to the side. I'm going to come here in the library. I'm going to get an image edit and drag it here. I'm going to come here. I'm going to leave it in full size. I'm going to come here in the image. I'm going to get the image of my logo, which is this one. I'm going to select it. I'm going to come here in the library. I'm going to search for menu. It was already there in front, but anyway, if you search, the WordPress menu will appear, which is the old navigation menu that we used. Then I'm going to put it here. I'm also going to go back to the library. I'm going to get a button edit, and I'm going to put it here. These are the three elements that I'm going to use. Then I'm going to come here in the main container. I'm going to come in style, type of background. I already have registered background colors here, so I'm going to click on the world. I'm going to get the color I want. If you don't have it, click here, paste the color here, or choose it here in the box. I'm going to click, I'm going to leave this background color here, then I can see my logo, you see that it's white. I'm going to come here in the header. I'm going to come in style. Then I'm going to adjust the header here the way I want it. I'm going to leave the color white. Here in the typography, I'm going to get, let me see, this text typography, which I already left in a nice size. If you don't have it configured, you come here, in the font family, put the font you want. I'm using Montserrat. Here you put the size. I'm using 15 weight 500, okay? Here on the button, I'll leave it written here. I'll come here in text. I'll write, ask for the budget, okay? Now I'm going to adjust the size here. We're going to work with percentages. First, I'm going to come here in the main content. I'm going to come in layout. I'm going to come here in space between the elements. I'm going to leave it in percentages. I'm going to put 2% spacing between them. I have two spaces here, you see? I have this first space that divides this and this, and this second space that divides this and this. I have two spacings of 2%, that is, I'm using 4% of space here, right? So if I have 100 here of free space, there will only be 96 left for me to work. I believe the logo here will take up about 35. There will be 61 left. I believe the button will take up about 15, and there will be 46 left for the header. So let's test it. I'm going to come here in the image. I'm going to come in advanced, in width. I'm going to leave it personalized. I have to leave it in percentages. I'm going to leave it 35. It got really big, so I'm going to decrease it here. Let me see. Look, 19 more or less. It's a nice size here. So, okay, I use 19, right? So 94 minus 19, 75 left. Let me see here how much spacing that will be cool for the button. I came in the button, I came in advanced. Width. I'm going to leave it personalized here. Leave it in percentages. Let's put 15, as I had thought. It got small, you see? It broke the line, so let me increase it a little bit. 16, it's already good. So, 75 minus 16, 59 left to use in the header. Then I'm going to come here. I'm going to come in advanced, width, leave it personalized here. I'm going to leave it in percentages, done, 59. Done. We are occupying 100% of the space here. Now I'm going to come here in the main container. I'm going to align them to the center, you see? One more up, one more down, and so it got cooler. So we've already set the spacing here. Our header is already working. I'm going to configure the logo here, which is usually the logo we put so that the person clicks and it brings it to the home page, right? So it's good for us to put a link. I'm going to come here in link, the personalized URL, and I'm going to put the link here from my site. If I write home here, it already pulls, you see? The home page, if not, you can come here, copy the link from your site and paste it here, okay? Here on the button, I'm going to send it to the contact page. So there's a link here. I'm going to send it to the contact page. So there's a contact page here. I'm going to write contact here too, which will already pull, in your case. If you want to send it to WhatsApp or anything else, you can come here and write too, okay? I'm seeing that after I put a link, it looks like it's... Oh no, look, it's just a little bug. It's working. Okay, now we're going to publish it for our header to appear on the site. We're going to come here and click on publish, then here we add a condition. By default, it already appears here. It appears on the whole site. Then you click here to save. Let's access our site here so we can see. It's already showing up here, you see? Oh, one thing I forgot to configure, these bars, I don't like them. Here, in my case, I want to remove this pointer, you see? So, you click here on header, then there's the pointer here, then I won't leave any, I'll just leave one color, you see? If you want to change this color, you come here in style, hover, then you can change the color here. And the active color you can also change here, okay? I'll click here to update. If we click here, it has already changed here for us, okay? We can also put a configuration on the button. I'll see it here on the button, style, hover, which is the action of moving the mouse. I'll leave it as grow, or it will stay like this. Like this. Look, it looks really cool like this. If you have done like me and put a header anchor in some parts, like this one in the portfolio, mine is already linking because I had already created it here, but I will teach you how to do it on yours too, okay? You come here on your page, remembering that it is only if you have done this one. If you have done, for example, put the pages like I did here on the contact page, you don't need to, okay? Look, I'm going to come here on my home page, then I will come here on the portfolio page, on the page, not on the part here, right? On the portfolio, I will click here on the container, I will come advanced, then here, look in ID, you will write the same ID that you put there on the link. Remember that we put it there in the header like this, look. Remember that we put it here, you see? It has to be the same. If you want, you can even copy and paste here to paste right, you see? So I created this. I also created the part about us, which is this one, right? So here, look, about us, and also in the part of FAQ.
It's here, right?
Look, you see, so that's it. Just put the link here with the page link, with hashtag and ID, and then here in the section you want, you come here, advanced. ID, you put the ID, then here you put the hashtag password, okay? Pay attention, here is the password, hashtag. I see a lot of people complaining that it's not working, and it's because of that, because it comes here and puts hashtag. Here is not to put, it's just on the link, okay? Beauty. And after you do that, you've already created the anchor here, then you can click that it comes straight here, okay? Another thing, if you left and want to change the header here again, there are two ways you can find it.
You can pass the mouse over here.
Elementor, and then it will be here, you see? The little model, you can click here, you will open the Elementor editor, or you come here inside the enterprise, here in models, models saved, click here on all, which will be here, you see? Main header, then just click here and edit with Elementor, which will open there, okay? Another thing, if you have saved before configuring the action and it is not appearing there on the site, just come here, you see? In this little triangle, click here to display conditions. Look, if it is like this, just click on Add Condition. There is a way for you to put it to appear on a specific page, too. If you don't want it to appear on the whole site, you come here, put it like this, here, singular, all singular. Then you select, for example, a page, pages, and then here you come and select the page. I want it to appear only on the contact page, then you will have saved to appear only on the contact page. If you want it to appear on the whole site, you can add an exclusion too. For example, I want it to appear on the whole site, except on the contact page, so you add one down here, then here you come and change to exclude, then you change here, look, to singular pages, then you come and add the contact page. Look, I'll save it here for you to see, then I'll access the site here, then the site will be working, normal. If I access the contact page, there will be no header here, because I excluded, you see? But if I come here and take it out and save it, then it will appear here on the contact page too, okay guys? There's just one thing left for us to configure in the layout, which is to configure it for mobile. So we, look, you come here, you see, click here, then there's how you configure it for cell phone, for tablet, and for desktop, which is computer. I'll teach you here for the cell phone, then you come here on the tablet and configure too, okay? Look, here on cell phone, I'll put it here, then I'll come. I'll come here on the header. I'll come here in advanced. I'll come here in width. I'll put personalized and I'll change to 70%. Oops, it has to be in percentage here, okay? So I put 70%, then I'll come here on the header. I'll come in advanced. I'll come here in width. I'll change to percentage and I'll put 28%, right? 70 plus 28 plus 2, which is the spacing, gives 100. Then they will stay here in the same line. And here this button, I'll come here. I'll come in advanced. I'll come in width. I'll leave it 100%. Then I'll come here in content. I'll leave it justified here. I'll come here in the container. I'll come here at the minimum height. I'll increase the height a little bit here so they don't get so stuck. I'll come here in the header. First, I'll come here in content, and I'll activate the total width so that it appears like this on the whole screen and not the way it was stretched. I'll come here in alternate button. I'll come here in color. I'll leave it white. I'll come here in background color. I'll put white too, but I'll come down here. I'll decrease the opacity until I leave only a background there, okay? Then it will look like this. Our header looks like this. Then when you click, it opens here. If you want, you can configure the background colors here in this drop-down header too. It is in this option here, list suspension. Then you can do all the color settings here too, okay? If you don't want this button to appear, you can come here in advanced, responsive, and hide it for cell phone and hide it for tablet, you see? Then it doesn't appear.
But if you do this, you can't increase the height here. I didn't even increase it, right? You have to leave it small so as not to have that space there, right? And then what you do here is just here on the cell phone and what you did on the computer continues. Just one thing that was missing to teach. If you want the header to follow the scroll of the screen, that is, it stays fixed. You come here in the container, come here advanced, come here in motion effects, and here in fixed you will leave the top. It may be that it is written top on yours too. You click here to update. And as we scroll the screen, it follows, I reloaded twice here, okay? Sometimes this happens to give a cache, and the first time you reload it doesn't show, but then just reload again that it will update, okay? That's it. I really hope you liked it. If you liked it, leave a like in the video, subscribe to the channel, a big hug, and see you next time. Bye!